Hey everyone, this is Noah from QuickNode coming at you with another video tutorial. In this one, we're going to be walking through the Ethers.js library and all that it allows you to do. In this one, we're going to connect to the blockchain, create a wallet, and send a transaction all using JavaScript. Without further ado, let's get into it. Here, I've initialized an empty repository called Ethers Tutorial. It's completely empty. So the first thing that we're going to do is go ahead and create a TypeScript file. So we're just going to touch index.ts. And so in our TypeScript, our index.ts file, we're going to install the Ethers library. So we're going to be using yarn. So we'll yarn add Ethers. Instead of yarn add, if you're using npm, this will be npm install or npm I ethers. And with that installed, we can go ahead and get into it. So the first thing that we'll need to do is import ethers from ethers. The next thing that we're going to do is create an anonymous asynchronous function that will run every single time we run this command. So in order to do that, we will just do one of these, and now everything that is within this block will get run every single time. And since it is an asynchronous function, we will have access to that await keyword. So the first thing that we're going to do is create a connection variable. So we'll do const connection. And then this is the first ethers call we're going to make is going to be a new ethers providers, and it's going to be a JSON RPC provider. And what we're going to pass into this string is going to be a URL to an endpoint. And so QuickNode makes this super easy. As you can see here, I've got, we're using the QuickNode API on the Rinkaby proof of authority test network. All I need to do is grab the HTTP provider from here and just paste it in, and boom, we're ready to go. Sure. If you are using this node in production, that you are either putting a whitelist on your endpoint so that only you can access it, or it's in an environment variable so no one else can see it, you'd preferably want to do both, because making certain commands can expose your key to the public network. For example, if it's in your front end, people are going to be able to see this. So you need to make sure that this is locked down properly. And to do that, you would just go over here to security, and you can set up referral whitelisting and domain masks here. And then if you do accidentally share your token, like I'm doing here, you can go ahead and roll that authentication token. So with that done, we now have a successful connection to the blockchain. And the first thing that we're going to need for this transaction is to get the price of gas. And so we're going to ask the blockchain for that. So we'll call this the gas price, and that's just going to be connection, and we're going to get the gas price. Boom, easy peasy. And the next thing that we're going to want to do is create a Ethers wallet. So you can see const wallet is going to be an Ethers wallet, and we want to we can do create random, and what this will do is create a fresh wallet every single time that it runs. And so what you would do is you would run this create random function, and this wallet, you could get its private key or its mnemonic from here. I already have one that's in place. And so what we will be using here is the from mnemonic method. And this from mnemonic phrase that we're going to use here is the seed phrase for any particular wallet. So I've already set one up and have some test ether in it. If you do not have any test ether, you can just Google Rinkaby faucet, and that will give you several different options, and you can paste whatever Ethereum address that you have into there. And so you can see here is mine. And again, this is incredibly sensitive information. This absolutely needs to be secured in some form or fashion if you are going to be using this in production. And so with a wallet that already has some funds in it, we can use this from mnemonic phrase, and that will give us access to these funds and be able to sign things, since it's already verified that this is in fact our wallet. The next thing that we're going to want to do is to create a signer function, because we don't want to be exposing this wallet variable anywhere. So we are actually going to use this ether signer method, which is going to be wallet.connect. and we're going to connect to the connection. So this signer has full access to our wallet's funds connected to the blockchain. As you can see, that is connected to our connection, which is our Ethers provider. With this, the next step is going to be to create a recipient that we can send our funds to. So our recipient will just be any Ethereum address. So this is one that I just picked up randomly from the chain and is one that I've used in other demos. And I know this one works, but again, you don't need to have any control over this particular address. You just need any address to send funds to. The next thing that we'll want to do is go ahead and create the transaction, which is going to be an object. So we'll have const tx for transaction, and that's going to be an object. And so it's going to have a couple of keys, and each of these keys will need a value. So our first key is from, and that's from us. So it's going to be the wallet.address. It's going to need a to key, and the value for that one will be recipient. It's going to need a value key, and that's going to use the Ethers utility library. And so whenever we need to access something that's going to deal with hexadecimal or hexadecimal formatting, we're going to lean on this library quite a bit. And so we're going to do Ethers utils, and we want to parse units. And this parse units function takes two arguments. The first one is going to be the amount of ether that we want to send. So I'm going to send 0.001. And then the second one is going to be the unit name, which is kind of the measurement that you're sending. So this could be wei, which is the smallest measurement, or ether, which is the largest measurement. There are many different ones, and you can find them all on the official Ethereum documentation. For this one, we are going to use Ether, which is the largest denomination of Ether. And the next thing that we'll want to do is put in the gas price that we got earlier. So gas price will be gas price. And the other thing that we'll want to add here is going to be the gas limit. And so the gas limit is going to be the uppermost value that you are comfortable paying in gas. So if the gas price is greater than the gas limit, it will revert the transaction and not submit it. So you can set this gas limit to be lower. Just know that your transaction may not go through for a really long period of time or indefinitely. So make sure that this is as low as you feel comfortable putting it, but at the same time, it does need to be high enough to get through the network. And so the gas limit is also expecting a hexadecimal number. And so again, we're going to be using these are Ethers utility library. And in this one, we're going to hexlify a number. So you can see here, we've got this hexlify method. And in here, we can just pass a number. And we'll call this 100,000, which given that this is wei, this would be equal to 100 gwei. The only other thing that we're going to need here is the nonce. The nonce is a number once, and it's always connected to your address. And this prevents duplicate transaction hashes from happening on the chain, as your nonce will increase every single time that you try to send a transaction. So if you sent the exact same transaction twice, it would not generate the same hash twice because your nonce would increment by one. And to grab that, we're just going to ask the blockchain. So we're going to do connection, and we're going to get the transaction count. So you can see here, get transaction count. And we want to get the transaction count of the wallet.address. And we want to get the transaction count of the latest point in time. You could also pass a block number here, and that would generate the nonce at a given point in time. So for example, say this is Vitalik's address, and you want to know at a certain block number that Vitalik, what his get transaction count was, you could pass his wallet into here, and then you could also just pass in at that block number, and that would give you his nonce at that certain point in time. There are many other keys that we could add to this transaction, but we're not going to go get into that. I believe there are between like 18 and 20 different keys that you could put in here. I think these six are a really good starting point. And if you need to customize your transaction further, you can do the digging in the Ethereum documentation to really see what the transaction object looks like in its entirety. So the last thing that we're going to do is send the transaction. And so that'll be, we'll call that transaction. and we're going to await our signer variable that we got earlier. So we'll do signer, and we're going to send the transaction. And what transaction are we going to send? We're going to send TX. Awesome. And so if we console log our transaction, and then we run this script, we should see all of that come out. So let's make sure this is nice and big so you can see it. Oh, and it looks like we've got an additional space in there. So that's not a valid recipient. So let's go ahead and do that again. Fantastic. And here you go. You can see the entirety of the transaction. We've got a bunch of different things here. You can see that it was from us. This is the wallet's public address. And most importantly, if you want to look this up, is going to be this hash right here. So we'll go ahead and copy this hash, and we will go over to the Rinkaby Etherscan, and we'll be able to look up this block hash. And you can see that this is you can actually see it's still indexing currently, but it's got everything going on. You can see it's a Rinkaby testnet transaction. It came from us and went to this other address, and boom, it's a success. It's got its own block number now and its timestamp. And that's how you create a wallet, signer, and connect to the blockchain and send a transaction, all using the Ethers.js library with a QuickNode RPC.